Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Gauri Mishra from Swami Shraddhanand College, University of Delhi. Today we are going to talk on module Plasmodium, Morphology and Life Cycle of Plasmodium from paper Biology of Parasitism. This module is being designed to understand the following aspects. First, the general aspects of Plasmodium, spectrum of Plasmodium infection, species of malarial parasite afflict human beings, morphology of different stages of Plasmodium, and the life cycle of Plasmodium, which is very important. Introduction. Plasmodium, an intracellular endoparasitic protozoans which passes on to the human beings by female Anopheles mosquito responsible for causing malaria. It is commonly called as a parasite, the malarial parasite. As you all know, protozoa are very small unicellular organisms. The malaria is one of the dreaded diseases of tropical countries and remain as an epidemic in more than 100 of countries. Deadly fevers, probably the malaria, have been recorded since the beginning of the written word, and references can be found in Vedic writings in India. The word malaria comes from the Italian word mala and aria, means the bad air. When the term was coined, it was commonly believed that malaria was caused by breathing of the bad air or gases above the marsh or the swamps. In 1980, the French army physician Lavin discovered Plasmodium, the causative agent of malaria, and subsequently in year 1897, Sir Ronald Ross, who is a very famous scientist, discovered malarial cyst in the stomach wall of Anopheles mosquito. For the same, he was honored with the Nobel Prize in 1902. In 1898, malaria transmission through the mosquito was established by an Italian scientist, Grassi. These discoveries transformed the phases of malarial research. Actually, the life history of malarial parasite is in two hosts. Henceforth, they are called as a diagenetic parasites. First, the vertebrate, which acts as an intermediate host of the parasite, and second, the mosquito, which is considered as the definite or the primary host because the sexual reproduction of the life cycle occurs in the mosquito. It comprises mainly of the two phases. First, an exogenous sexual phase, exo means the outer, with the multiplication in certain Anopheles mosquito, and the second phase, the asexual phase, which is the endogenous phase called as schizogony, in which the multiplication is occurring in the vertebrate host.
A spectrum of Plasmodium infection. There are more than 120 species of Plasmodium which are known to infect various groups of vertebrates. Few of them are as follows. Human parasite. The four species of Plasmodium which are known to infect humans are Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale, and Plasmodium malariae. Out of the four species mentioned, Plasmodium falciparum is the major cause of morbidity and mortality. Recently, Plasmodium knowlesi has been reported to cause infection in human beings, which is known to infect monkeys. Rodent parasites. The four species are well known to infect rodent, which can be differentiated on the basis of the erythrocytic cycle, synchronicity, and preference to infect differentially aged RBC. For example, Plasmodium yoeli and Plasmodium burgai. Simenon parasite. There are 20 species of Plasmodium which are believed to infect monkeys and apes with a range of similar biological characteristics to that of human parasites. For example, Plasmodium fragile and Plasmodium hylobati. Avian parasite. Plasmodium falix and Plasmodium reticulum are the important common most avian malarial parasite. These species differ from the mammalian parasite in having different site of pre-erythrocytic schizogony. The site of pre-erythrocytic schizogony in avian parasite is mesoderm, while in mammals it is the liver parenchyma. Reptilian parasites. The only reptilian species of Plasmodium is Plasmodium venioni, which infects these snakes. Malarial parasites are very common in lizards while absent in crocodiles. Species of malarial parasite afflict human beings. Various species of Plasmodium infect humans to produce different symptoms and periodicity, which are as follows. The first, Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax causes benign tertiary malaria. Primarily, the symptoms include headache, nausea, anorexia, and vomiting. Other symptoms include respiration, shivers, and very high fever. Plasmodium ovale. Plasmodium ovale causes ovale malaria. The symptoms are comparable to benign tertiary malaria. If left untreated, it can last for about 1 year. Plasmodium malaria. Plasmodium malaria causes quaternary malaria. The bouts of temperature are of 72 hours periodicity. The symptoms are much similar to benign tertiary malaria. Untreated cases can last about 20 years. The last, Plasmodium falciparum. Plasmodium falciparum causes malignant tertiary malaria, which is the lethal form of malaria. Symptoms are similar to flu with daily shivers, temperature, intense nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Crisis reappears every 36 to 48 hours. In this, brain is more frequently affected. The unique property of causing agent is secretion with endothelial wall of capillaries causing brain hemorrhage. This eventually leads to either coma or death of the infected individual. Renal lesions are found to infect individuals. Because of vomiting and diarrhea, liver is also affected, which causes rapid dehydration. Morphology of Plasmodium. The blood stages of human Plasmodium species exhibit different morphology and modification in the host erythrocyte. The difference can be used to distinguish the four species. Plasmodium falciparum blood stages are characterized by the presence of slightly smaller and numerous ring stages than the other species. Erythrocytes having multiple infections are seen more often in Plasmodium falciparum than in the other species. Distinct crescent-shaped gametocytes of Plasmodium falciparum reappear late in the infection. Plasmodium vivax with enlarged infected erythrocytes and granules called as Schaffner dots over the erythrocyte cytoplasm manifest a vesicle complex that form on the erythrocyte membrane. The trophozoite of Plasmodium vivax has an amoeboid appearance. The schizons have more than 20 merozoites. Plasmodium ovale also exhibits Schaffner's dot with an enlarged erythrocyte. It is difficult to distinguish the infection of Plasmodium vivax. In general, Plasmodium ovale is a more compact parasite than Plasmodium vivax. This instance is most evident in the growing trophozoid stage. Merozoites are fewer per schizon. Elongated host erythrocytes are found in case of Plasmodium ovale. Plasmodium malaria exhibits compact stages and does not modify the host erythrocyte except few elongated trophozoites which stretches along the erythrocyte to form a band-like structure. Schizons will typically have 8 to 10 merozoites, often arranged in an rosette pattern with a clump of pigment in the center. A comparative account of various stages of the four plasmodium are being described below as given in the table, which clearly represents the disparity in the morphological appearance of the four species. As such, the Plasmodium falciparum stipules have a large red spot which is called as Moro's dot. Plasmodium vivax has a small red dot which is called as a Schaffner dot. Plasmodium malaria dot is a very small tiny dot which is called as Zeeman's dot. Plasmodium ovale has numerous small red dots called as James dot. The pigment color of each differs. For example, Plasmodium falciparum has usually a black or a dark brown color. Plasmodium vivax has a golden brown granule. Plasmodium malaria has a black or a coarse brown granule. And similarly, Plasmodium ovale granule is much similar to Plasmodium malaria pigment. The salient features of the four species are: in Plasmodium falciparum, a small compact dark staining parasite is seen, and the multiple infections of single RBCs. A light large staining embryoid parasite with many trophozoite is seen in case of Plasmodium vivax. A regular shape, strong tendency to form a band across the infected RBC is seen in Plasmodium malaria. In Plasmodium ovale, a regular shape and much similar to the size of Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium malaria is similar to the Plasmodium ovale. Common stages present in the four species are the trophozoites, the schizonts, and the gametocytes. In Plasmodium falciparum, only rings and gametocyte stages are visible. The ring stage is very delicate, small, and double chromatin and multiple rings of Plasmodium falciparum. There is a large, usually a single ring with a chromatin thicker with a prominent chromatin in Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium malaria has a very similar ring to that of Plasmodium vivax, but it is comparatively thicker. The ring stage of Plasmodium ovale is similar to Plasmodium vivax, but compact. The trophozoite stage of Plasmodium parasites, such as that of Plasmodium falciparum, is compact with a smaller vacuole which is inconspicuous. In Plasmodium vivax, the trophozoite stage is large, irregular vacuole with a prominent chromatin as dots or threads. The trophozoite stage is characterized in Plasmodium malaria with a band-like formation and vacuole is inconspicuous. In Plasmodium ovale, the trophozoite is compact, rough pigment, large irregular clumps of chromatin are seen. Schizont of Plasmodium falciparum is small, compact, and is rarely seen in the blood smear. The schizont of Plasmodium vivax is large, filling the RBC, segmented, yellow-brown pigment. The Plasmodium malaria schizont is segmented, clearly fills the RBC, and is dark brown in color. Schizont of Plasmodium ovale fills 3/4 of the RBC, segmented, and the pigment color ranges from dark yellow to brown. The microgametes of Plasmodium vivax is filling the RBC, large, round, ovale, compact, and blue in color. Plasmodium falciparum, the microgamete are larger than the RBC, kidney shape with a blunt round end. Cytoplasm is reddish blue and may have many fine granules in smear. Plasmodium malaria, the microgametes are smaller than the RBC, few in number at the peripheral blood flip, round, compact, with a pale blue cytoplasm. Pigment and chromatin are same as that of the Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium ovale, the microgametes are round, compact, very few in the peripheral blood film. Cytoplasm is pale blue. Chromatin and pigment are same as that of the Plasmodium vivax. Macrogametes. Macrogametes of Plasmodium falciparum are slender, nucleus small, compact, and closely aggregated. Plasmodium vivax, large, loose, ill-defined mass of chromatin and a smaller mass. The macrogametes of Plasmodium malare is same as that of Plasmodium vivax, with a low number appearing after 12 to 14 days. Plasmodium ovale is that very much similar to Plasmodium vivax, low number appearing after 12 to 14 days. A diagrammatic illustration of the morphology of the different stages of the Plasmodium species life cycle in the thin blood films is easily illustrated, and the difference can be well marked in the following table. Structure of Plasmodium merozoid. Merozoid is an ovoid cell that measures approximately 1.5 micron in length and 1 micron in width. The apical end is like truncated cone-shaped projection demarcated by the polar rings. Three types of membrane-bound organelles are rhopatids, which are the prominent pear-shaped bodies, micronemes, which are ovoid bodies, and dense granules, which are spheroid vesicles, are present at the anterior end of the merozoid. The function of these organelles is related to the binding and entry of the merozoid into the host cell. Merozoids are basically short-lived and need to evade a new host erythrocyte just after the release. A trilaminar pellicle surrounds the merozoid, which is composed of a plasma membrane and two closely aligned inner membranes. Beneath this inner membrane complex is a row of subpellicular microtubules radiating posteriorly from the polar ring of the apical end. The inner membrane complex and subpellicular microtubule function as a cytoskeleton, giving rigidity to the merozoid. Mitochondrion are generally acristy or with a few cristae. The epicloroplast is believed to be evolutionary homologue of the plant chloroplast. A single vesicular nucleus with a centrally located nucleolus is also present in merozoid. The next stage is the infective stage, called as sporozoid. The most versatile of the invasive stages of the Plasmodium life cycle are the sporozoids. During the passage from the mosquito vector to the vertebrate host, sporozoids exhibit diverse behaviors, including gliding locomotion, invasion, migration, and egress from the target cells. These functions are performed by rhopatids and micronemes, which are the only secretory organelle around the apical cap. Finally, the sporozoid evade hepatocyte and transformed into exoerythrocytic stages, continuing the life cycle of the erythrocytic part in RBC. Now, the life cycle of malarial parasite. The life cycle of a malarial parasite is very complex. It's a diagenetic parasite. A diagenic parasite is a parasite which requires two hosts to complete its cycle. The life cycle of all species of human parasite is essentially the same. It comprises an exogenous, the sexual phase called as sporogony, with multiplication in certain Anopheles mosquito, and the second stage is an endogenous asexual phase called as schizogony, with multiplication in the vertebrate host. The later phase includes the development cycle in the red cells, which is called as erythrocytic schizogony, and the phase taking place in the parenchyma cells of the liver are called as the pre-erythrocytic schizogony. The vertebrate act as an intermediate host or a secondary host, while the mosquito is considered to be a definite or a primary host, as sexual reproduction takes place in mosquito.
First stage, the exoerythrocytic stage, which occurs in human malaria. Sporozoites are the infective stages. Malaria infection in human starts with the infection of the bloodstream during a blood meal by an infectious mosquito. The circulatory period of the sporozoite is short and just for about 60 minutes, after which they actively enter the liver of the host. Sporozoites die shortly after invasion in the Kupffer cells of the liver, as these are resistant to the sporozoites. Most of the sporozoites enter the hepatocytes to begin the asexual exoerythrocytic schizogonic cycle. This cycle is actually not in the erythrocytes, that means the red blood cells, henceforth the term exoerythrocytic schizogony is given. The liver trophozoites, a mononucleated round bodies, divides asexually to form a mature multinucleated schizont, which finally releases a large number of merozoites. The number of merozoites produced at the end of this cycle is also dependent upon the species of the parasites. As discussed, we have four different type of species. The merozoites are released into the sinusoids of the liver by the rupture of the liver schizonts. Released merozoites invade the RBCs, that is the red blood cells. Two species of human malaria parasite show relapses are Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale, where some of the liver trophozoites immediately starts the exoerythrocytic schizogony, while the other remain in a dormant stage, and these are termed as hypnozoites. The next phase is the erythrocytic stages of human malarial parasite. The intricate and varying spectrum of symptoms characterizing the disease of human is due to the erythrocytic stages of malarial parasite. The recognition of parasites in the blood of the patient allow the diagnosis of the infection and the differentiation of the various species. The time required to complete the erythrocytic cycle is a fixed characteristic of a parasite species, which is enumerated in the table given. Merozoites initiate the blood phase of the life cycle on rupture and then discharge of the liver schizont into the circulations. The merozoite possess a single nucleus and adjacent to the cytoplasm with a diameter of 1 micrometer. It invades immediately and the erythrocyte to develop a trophozoite stage. The young trophozoite feeds on the erythrocytes, produces a vacuole which assumes a characteristic ring form. This stage is referred as signet ring stage. Approximately in 80s hour expansion of cytoplasm and disappearance of vacuole takes place, and there is an appearance of a characteristic parasitic pigment within the cytoplasm. Pigments are known as hemozoin pigments, and the color of these pigments are yellow-brown, which are formed due to the parasite indention of the hemoglobin and decomposition of the same into the protein and hematin. Protein is used as a food, whereas the unused hematin forms toxic.
Characteristic features of four species of human Plasmodium. The Plasmodium vivax has a pre-erythrocytic cycle of 8 days, Plasmodium ovale of 9 days, Plasmodium malariae of 13 days, and Plasmodium falciparum, which is the fetal of all, having a pre-erythrocytic cycle of 5 to 6 days. The pre-patent period is of 11 to 13 days in Plasmodium vivax, 10 to 14 days is Plasmodium ovale, 15 to 16 days in Plasmodium malaria, and 9 to 10 days in Plasmodium falciparum. Incubation period. Incubation period of Plasmodium vivax is 13 days, Plasmodium ovale 17 days, Plasmodium malaria 28 days, and Plasmodium falciparum 12 days. Number of merozoites per tissue schizont number in Plasmodium vivax is 10,000, 15,000 in Plasmodium ovale, 2,000 in Plasmodium malaria, and 40,000 in Plasmodium falciparum. Hypnozoites are present in Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale, but absent in Plasmodium malaria and Plasmodium falciparum. Erythrocytic cycle lasts for 48 hours in Plasmodium vivax, 50 hours in Plasmodium ovale, 72 hours in Plasmodium malaria, and Plasmodium falciparum has an erythrocytic cycle of 48 hours. A typical malarial paroxysm is determined by erythrocytic rupture to release the merozoites into the bloodstream. Merozoites release into the circulations invade new erythrocytes to repeat the schizogony until the process is inhibited by the specific immune response or by chemotherapy. Some of the merozoites differentiate into sexual forms called as gametocytes in the course of erythrocytic schizogony, which remain inside the RBCs. Gametocytes become visible approximately from the third generation in case of Plasmodium vivax, ovale, and malaria, while in case of Plasmodium falciparum, it requires approximately 10 generations for appearance of gametocytes, which probably reflects the slow maturation and secretion of the immature stages in this species. Gametocytes of Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale, Plasmodium malaria are morphologically similar to the late trophozoites, while Plasmodium falciparum gametocytes present a crescent shape. In the peripheral blood, two types of gametocytes, the female macrogametocytes and the male microgametocytes, are present. They can be differentiated on the basis of nuclear material, which is dispersed in the male parasite, preparing it for the exflagellation, while condensed in female parasite. The next is the sexual cycle in the mosquito, which is the definite host or the primary host. Protein required for the egg formation of female Anopheles mosquito come through the bloodstream. Oviposition continues throughout the life of the female mosquito, which requires repeated contacts with the vertebrate host for the blood meal. These subsequent feedings allow malarial parasite its multiplication, maturation, and transmission to the other individual. The sexual cycle starts with the ingestion of mature female and male gametocyte by a suitable species of Anopheles during a blood meal. In the midgut of insect, the female gametocyte get rid of the cover of RBCs to remain free in the extracellular space as microgamete. The male gametocyte nucleus divides into 8 sperm-like flagellated microgametes through exflagellation, which arrive at midgut and actively move to fertilize a macrogamete. After fertilization, a zygote is formed, which develops slowly into a motile oogonete in approximately 15 hours. The oogonete ruptures the peritrophic membrane and the epithelium of the midgut to inhabit below the basal lamina of the outer gut wall. In 24 to 72 hours after the blood meal, the oogonite develops into a non-motile oocyst. Narrow and curved sporozoids are produced from oocysts on maturation, which are actively motile about 15 micrometer in length. The sporozoites migrate and reach the salivary glands by making small perforation in the wall of the cyst. Sporozoite penetrate the basal membrane of salivary gland and settle into the salivary duct. During the mosquito blood feeding, the salivary fluid content, which contains an anti-clotting property with sporozoites, are actively injected into the human host to start another asexual cycle.
So student, now let us summarize what we have learnt in this module. Plasmodium is an intracellular endoparasitic protozoan and causes malaria. Malaria is one of the most dreaded diseases of tropical countries. There are more than 120 species of plasmodiums known to infect various groups of vertebrates. Among those, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale, and Plasmodium malaria can infect human beings. The malignant tertiary malaria caused by Plasmodium falciparum is the most lethal one. The blood stages of human Plasmodium species exhibit different type of morphologies and modification in the host erythrocyte. A fifth species, Plasmodium nullesi, has been recently identified as a clinically significant pathogen in human. There is an emerging infection of malaria in Southeast Asia. Merozoite is an ovoid cell with an apical truncated cone-shaped projection which is demarcated by the polar rings. Three types of membrane-bound organelles, which are rupturized, the two prominent pear-shaped structures, the micronemes, ovoid bodies, and the dense granules, which are the spheroid vesicles, are present at the anterior end of the merozoite. The function of these organelles is related to the binding and the entry of the merozoite in the host cell. The most versatile and infective stage of Plasmodium life cycle is the sporozoite. The life cycle of malaria parasite is very complex. It's a diagenetic parasite which requires two hosts to complete its life cycle. It comprises of the first, exogenous, the sexual phase called as sporogony, with multiplication in certain Anopheles mosquito, and the second, which is called as the endogenous asexual phase, termed as schizogony, with multiplication in the vertebrate host. The vertebrate act as an intermediate or a secondary host for the parasite, while mosquito is called as the definite host, the primary host. Primary host is one in which the sexual reproduction takes place. The two species of parasite, that is Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale, show relapses where dormant stage hypnozoites are present. Erythrocytic stage include a signet ring stage, a mature trophozoite, which is actually the feeding stage, and the schizonts. The female macrogametocytes and the male microgametocytes can be differentiated on the basis of the nuclear material, which is dispersed in male parasite, which is used for preparing for the process called as exflagellation in mosquitoes, and very much condensed in female parasite. Mosquito, which is a polykilothermic host, affects the speed of the cycle since it strongly depends upon the temperature and other climatic factors. Sporozoites, which is actually the infective stage, find way to get accumulated in the salivary gland of the female Anopheles for the next cycles in the humans. Thank you so much, dear friends,